this is a disease that has gone on for 40 years, and we don't have any drugs, we don't have any vaccines that work for it, that we know for sure.
Vaccine development is a long process, and we have to prioritize what we develop vaccines for. One of the reasons we do not have an Ebola vaccine is that there was not a concern that Ebola was going to spread widely.
You don't have direct numbers on it, but it is something to keep in mind that there are lots of people out there who apparently have been exposed and they are currently immune. And it had been noted in previous outbreaks that family members, you would have family members taking care of the dead, and some would get sick and some wouldn't get sick. So presumably the ones who didn't get sick were the ones who were immune for whatever reason. And that's a really good thing to know, because that means that you can get a vaccine that will work.
What we desperately need, and there has been work going on this, is therapy, treatment, because we really don't have good treatment. And some of the experimental treatments that have been used have been antibodies that have been produced which seem to be able to control the infection.
This actually raises a whole set of other questions on when we make vaccines that haven't been safe and effective through the FDA approval process available. There is a case to be made, because of the enormous population health consequences, that moving these vaccines to the hard-hit countries may be our best mechanism against further spread.
I would put the priority here on developing treatment. We need better treatment. And the problem is that nobody envisioned the large number of cases that we have right now.